What's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back in again with another video. So I was able to check out a couple of clips from Monday Night Raw. Once again, you guys know I don't really watch Raw too much, not even like the full show or even half the show. I usually just watch the important clips to kind of keep up a little bit with what's going on storyline wise, but that's pretty much what I did here. I checked out a few clips actually. I checked out Goldberg and Drew McIntyre coming back, and I also checked out the Alexa Bliss segment with Randy Orton, and probably the most notable thing that in my opinion that happened on the show is Edge confirming his return to the Royal Rumble. So let's start with Drew McIntyre returning back after a couple weeks of, you know, dealing with the COVID situation. He cut a really emotional promo, very heartfelt. It's good to see him back healthy, you know, doing what he loves, and all the people that sent him, you know, get well wishes. That's amazing, you know what I'm saying? Like I said in the video where I pretty much talked about it, it's COVID is a real thing. You know, one of my close family members just recently caught it, so it's something serious, and you know, you definitely got to take it seriously. So it's good to see that he's able to compete for the Royal Rumble so he can go against none other than Goldberg. I really don't want to see this match. I don't think this match should happen. I think this is a waste of a potential opportunity for somebody else to get the spotlight, but instead you give it to Goldberg. Don't know why. If Drew loses this match, WWE, they just don't care about their current talent. If Drew loses this match, I just give up on WWE when it comes to the main roster side, especially on the Raw side of things. Vince doesn't know what he's doing, so keep my fingers crossed that Goldberg does not win, but you never know with this company. Now, the segment that I didn't really get is when Miz and Morrison came out, and Miz still had the Money in the Bank briefcase. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, but I could have sworn the Miz cashed in his Money in the Briefcase at TLC, and he lost the match. So how? Let me know. I don't watch Raw much. Let me know how he was able to get the Money in the Briefcase back. But that doesn't make sense. Like, it doesn't matter what match you cash it in on. If you lose that match, you lose the opportunity. So how did he cash it in at TLC but still has the briefcase? Somebody let me know. I don't feel like doing the research to even figure that out, because to me, that doesn't even make sense. But the Money in the Bank is not what it used to be anyway. The Money in the Bank briefcases, it doesn't have that much weight like it used to. So that's neither here nor there. So that kind of confused me. But other than that, it was good to see Drew back, but I don't care for the match. Not looking forward to this match. If it's not a squash match, it's a waste of time. Next thing I want to talk about is Alexa Bliss and her character, like character transformation. I know she's in line with The Fiend. She's been doing some crazy stuff the past couple weeks. Apparently, I did see the clip where she blew some fire at Randy Orton and it messed up his face. Like, I thought that was quite comical. So she's going through her little phase, and I believe she had a match with Asuka for the Raw Women's Championship. And it was like she was transforming mid-match. One, like at the beginning of the match, she's the current character that she is, and then in the middle of the match, it's like she transformed into her old Alexa Bliss gimmick, and then she transformed into, towards the end of the match, like this Fiend hybrid of Alexa Bliss. Like it's like she's no selling moves, she's powering out of moves, she's using the mandible claw. Like, I don't know, it was just kind of a little hokey to me. Once again, it's just like, I don't know about that. But then Randy Orton pops up from behind, and he's quote unquote still disfigured from the fire. He got fire burn marks all over his face, all over his face. It's just like the fire didn't really just hit him like they're trying to portray it. Like it's actually kind of funny to me. Like, trust and believe, if he literally got his face set on fire, he would not be wrestling. But nevertheless, he comes out there from behind and he hits Alexa Bliss with RKO. It's not too many times Randy Orton hitting women with RKOs, but when he does, it's pretty devious. But it's like, can you blame him? She set the nigga face on fire. I don't condone women being hit or hit with RKOs, but I'm just saying. Anywho, point is, that segment was kind of weird to me as well. I don't know, the hokiness of wrestling is, it's always been there. You know, I think it works better in the 80s and the 90s, but since social media is so prevalent, it's like everything's just, you can get at your fingertips on your phone. It's just like that whole segment with Alexa Bliss changing characters mid-match, it was just kind of cringe to me. But comment down below, let me know if you like that, like the way her character is kind of changing. And obviously, in my opinion, the highlight of the show, or the clips that I did see, in my opinion, is none other than Edge returning back to the Royal Rumble 1 year, you know, run 1 year removed from when he returned, when he came back to the Royal Rumble last year in 2020. So it's kind of crazy that he's coming back again in 2021. This is dope. This add a little bit of more dynamic to who could possibly win the Royal Rumble this year. Do I think Edge is gonna win it? There's a good possible chance Edge could win the Royal Rumble. Not even gonna lie to you. I'm still riding with Daniel Bryan, in my opinion. I think Daniel Bryan and potentially him going against Roman Reigns would be the better story, but I'm not sure, you know what I'm saying? But I will say this promo that he delivered was very powerful, very impactful. And the theme of the promo is, life is so like short and ever changing. One minute you think things are gonna go your way, and then the next minute it completely changes. Your whole direction and sense of accomplishment changes because of one thing. And he was talking about when he won the championship years ago, 10 years ago, and then he had to relinquish it because he had to retire pretty much. And then when he comes back and he's, you know, he's got this momentum, and then he ends up, you know, ends up getting injured and he has to sit down on the shelf. Like, that's kind of what life is, and you know, not giving up from that. It was a very emotional promo. Nothing let, you know, I expect that from Edge, you know what I'm saying? He's definitely gotten much better on the mic skills over the years. So honestly, I'm very intrigued now even more with the Royal Rumble match, because I want to see who can possibly win this. Still, the match for me that I'm looking forward to the most is, of course, Roman Reigns and Kevin Owens. I still think that's going to be the marquee match. But the Royal Rumble just got even more interesting just because Edge got involved. So I would love to see how this is going to play out. So comment down below. Let me know. Do you guys think Edge is going to be the favorite now? Since he's announced himself in the Royal Rumble this coming Sunday, do you think he is going to be the favorite to win? Or do you guys still have Daniel Bryan? Some of you guys are saying, y'all have, I think a couple of you guys are saying Shinsuke could be the potential winner. Like, I want to get your opinion. Who do y'all think is going to win the Royal Rumble this year? I'm still going with Daniel Bryan, but hey, I wouldn't trip if Edge won it. You know what I'm saying? I think if they're going to go somewhere with this, it has to be somebody that they can build a storyline with into WrestleMania. And with Edge, you can easily do that with Edge, because he hasn't really faced anybody except Randy Orton. And I would love for them to revisit that so they can finish that feud off potentially. Or if you want to go Daniel Bryan, you know, Daniel Bryan got some history with Roman Reigns. I think that would be cool too. So, and you know, Shinsuke, you can go Shinsuke route. He got some issues with Roman Reigns. Like, it's there's plenty of ways they can take this. So comment down below, let me know y'all thoughts and opinions on who y'all think is going to win the Royal Rumble this Sunday. But I can't wait to check it out for you guys. I'm gonna have my thoughts and opinions. I'm gonna record it that night and post it that night for you guys, so be on the lookout for that. But I appreciate all the love and support, bro, to 40k. Appreciate y'all. Kiki D would be, and I'll see y'all on the next one. Peace.